In this video, we're going to show you how you can display flight sim charts from Jeppesen inside Microsoft Flight Simulator for Xbox.
Hey everyone, and welcome to this video from our Stockholm office, where we have moved out from our usual studio and into our lounge area. So today we're testing the new FlightFX HJet for Microsoft Flight Simulator, which is available from the MSFS Marketplace for $25. It's available for both PC and Xbox. The aircraft can carry up to 7 passengers at a maximum speed of 0.70 Mach and reaches over 1200 nautical miles. Cruising at 43,000 feet with this aircraft will surely give you some stunning views of the world in MSFS. Now, the cockpit is equipped with a sophisticated G3000 unit that has a touchscreen controller which allows you to control things like checklists, V-speeds, loading, cargo, and more. The multifunction display allows you to show Jeppesen charts inside Microsoft Flight Simulator even on Xbox, and I'm now going to hand over to my colleague Malin, who will show you how to set it up.
To view charts inside the HJet, start off by signing up for an ultimate subscription on Navigraph.com if you haven't already done so. This will provide you with access to our apps that includes the Jeppesen electronic charts library for over 7,000 airports worldwide. In this video, we will show you how to set up the charts integration for the HJet on Xbox, but the steps will be the same on PC. The touchscreen controllers of the HJet sit just below the multifunction display. We set up the charts integration from this interface. Click on the Utilities button, then click Setup. Go to Database Status, then click Navigraph Charts. We'll now link our Navigraph account to the HJet by following the instructions on the touchscreen controller. Remember to authenticate using the credential for your account that has an active Ultimate subscription. The HJet uses the G3000 system from Working Title, which enables the charts to be viewed on the multifunction display. The last step in the linking process is to press Link Account on the touchscreen controller. We have now successfully linked our Navigraph account. Press the rightmost soft key below the multifunction display to get started. We can now click Home and select the charts from the Charts button on the touchscreen controller as seen here.
Alright, so thanks a lot, Malin. Now let's talk a little bit about Microsoft Flight Simulator for Xbox, as some of you may wonder if this is something for you. Every year we run a Flight Sim community survey. Last year we had over 24,000 respondents, and the statistics show that 5% of the respondents owned an Xbox Series X or S. And just over half of them stated that they fly simulators on Xbox. Will these numbers go up this year? Most probably they will, as more functionality is now brought across to the Xbox platform. Do we think that Xbox will be able to replace a flight simulation PC? Well, maybe not, as there are things that you can do on a PC that you currently can't do on an Xbox, as there are add-ons, mods, and hardware that are not available for this platform just yet. Just like many other developers within the community, we at Navigraph intend to bring across as many of our functionalities as possible as soon as we're able to do so. We're also working to facilitate developers by making it as easy as possible for those who intend to integrate charts into their add-ons for Xbox. If you are a developer and would like to know more, drop us a line at dev@navigraph.com. Now, we believe in the Xbox platform, as we understand that flight simmers may not always look for the true-to-life airline pilot experience, where you create a flight plan in sim briefs, set up the aircraft from cold and dark, fly from A to B according to the SOP of your virtual airline. Sometimes you may be time limited and just want to get up in the air and enjoy some nice views, shoot some eyeless approaches, and that's it. This is one of the use cases where we think that the console can be a great platform. If you have already purchased the Microsoft Store version of Microsoft Flight Simulator for PC, you will also have the Xbox version, so it can be a good complement to your PC, as it's easy to head out for a flight and you're less likely to find yourself spending the same amount of time on the ground setting up and updating your simulator, add-ons, and hardware. And we also think that Xbox can serve you well if you're just starting out with flight simming and you don't want to spend the time and money required to get a flawless experience in MSFS on a PC. The Xbox only costs a fraction of the PC that has the recommended specs for MSFS, and you're still getting a decent performance from it. Now, we would like to know what you think about flight simulation for Xbox. Let us know in the comment section. Until next time, take care.